officials from the Ministry of Education have threatened to close schools that have hiked school fees, but at the same time are also pressurizing parents to put their children in boarding schools. Investigations also will also be launched into schools that are said to be illegally letting other classes, which have not been officially opened by the government, to operate. The concern was raised by the Director of Education Standards at the Ministry of Education, Kedris Turiagenda, during an interaction with journalists in Kampala today.
Ever since the opening of schools to some classes, some schools have taken advantage of the situation to hike fees and also force learners into boarding section. The Permanent Secretary for the Ministry of Education, Alex Kakoza, maintains that it is an illegality for schools to increase fees without first seeking for the consent of the Ministry of Education. He has therefore called upon the affected parents to log in a formal complaint so they can take action.
If someone, you know, takes back learners of classes that have not yet been called, it's irregular, he's breaking the law, and it should be reported. Just like the schools that are increasing school fees.
School managements have also been warned against pressurizing learners into boarding section. They have been advised to instead ensure that students learn in shifts so that those in day don't mix with those in the boarding section to avoid the risk of spreading COVID-19 pandemic.
No one should be forcing a parent or a learner really to join a boarding school if that learner doesn't wish to do so, especially if that school is not, you know, a boarding school or is a day and boarding, and therefore this learner has opted to be in a day school. No one should do it, and when he does it, it's irregular.
If you relax as a head teacher and your school is no longer meeting the basics, we can ask you to close. So I want to appeal to all schools, all school leaders, to ensure that they continually observe the SOPs as they are doing as they open for the learners.
The officials also disclosed investigations into schools that are letting in learners for other classes that have not been officially opened by government. However, a green light was given to special schools for learners with special needs to operate for all classes, provided they have capacity to adhere to the COVID-19 guidelines.
The Permanent Secretary of Ministry of Local Government has once again asked his local government leaders, the COWs and town clerks, to ensure that every school is inspected and that Directorate of Education Standards gets regular reports. And they are doing that, so we have reports to give us confidence that there is space, but that also our children will be there and will be safe.
With government reopening classes in a phased manner, the education experts have expressed a need for the education ministry to put in the education curriculum more lessons to do with the counseling of the learners, since many were traumatized and some sexual abused during the long holiday due to the lockdown.
Ministry of Health and Ministry of Education to come up with a program within the timetable to be able to share age-appropriate information with these children, because we can no longer put our heads in the sand. I mean, the sexuality framework is there that was approved, but it is not being implemented in the schools. That's why Stepping Stone, we came up with a curriculum. We offer age-appropriate information, meaning that a child of senior 1 and 2 is having a different curriculum from an A-level student.
I'm Juliet Namwaya, reporting for the news in Kampala.